Hi, hello to all. Today we are going to see about the comparison of Poco M2 and Poco M2 Pro. Come on, let's go into the video. So before entering to this video, don't forget to subscribe our channel and click the bell icon. I have just received the Poco M2 Pro mobile, which was ordered through the Flipkart before a week. It's a pretty good experience to get the hands on the Poco M2 Pro, which has a glossy black, feels like a flagship mobile, comes with the Gorilla Glass 5 protection. Speaking of the Gorilla Glass 5 protection, the Poco M2 Pro also comes with a Gorilla Glass 5 protection on its big display of 6.67 inch with a high resolution of Full HD Plus combined with an LCD panel of 60Hz refreshment rate. The processor included with this phone has a good combination of the mid-range chip from the Qualcomm Limited. The phone comes with an Snapdragon 720G chipset, which has a 2.3 GHz core as a primary clock speed and has 6 cores as 1.8 GHz core, which gives an extremely super nice performance. The mobile also have a big battery of 5000 mAh, which supports 33 watts fast charging with a Type-C cable port, which was included in the box itself. As we all know about the Poco, the Poco is the sub-brand of the Xiaomi Private Limited. So this phone runs with an MIUI. The phone comes with an MIUI 12, which has the basic primary operating system of Android version 10. I'm really impressed with the Poco M2 Pro's performance because it combined with a good combination of Snapdragon 720G chipset and an MIUI 12. So it gives neat and clean performance, which gives the user extremely smooth experience. I didn't even notice any of those lags or hanging issues while using the phone with light usage or intensively playing games with the high graphics, but there is no issues at all. And I definitely would say that the phone has no eating issues. The phone's build quality is also so good. Speaking about the build quality, the Poco M2 Pro weighs 184 grams. And the weight is evenly distributed, so the weight management of this Poco M2 Pro is really great. The Poco M2 Pro has also have the IR blaster, which gives us to control our television and air conditioner, etc. This is a special feature where the IR blaster is only available on the Poco and the Mi mobiles. Next up, it's the camera. The Poco M2 Pro's camera is good enough and it takes decent photos, which has the rear quad camera setup, which contains 48 megapixel as a primary sensor with an 8 megapixel of an ultra-wide sensor and a 5 megapixel of a macro sensor and also a 2 megapixel depth sensor. Whereas in front, there is a single punch hole camera with a 16 megapixel primary lens. The videos of this Poco M2 Pro can push up to 4K at 60fps in rear, whereas in front, the video quality is also good in front and it supports up to 4K at 30fps. Next, the phone's sound quality. The phone gives a clean and neat sound while the speaker is at the bottom and the sounds are clear and very louder. In YouTube, the sound is clear, but the image resolution can push up to only 480 pixels. But some of the phones can push up to 480 pixels only, so it's not a big problem. And while in other apps, it can play up to Full HD Plus resolution. Now it's time for the Poco M2. Coming to the Poco M2, the mobile also comes with an Full HD Plus resolution display with an 6.53 inch LCD panel, which supports 60Hz refreshment rate. The Poco M2 uses the MediaTek's budget processor called the MediaTek Helio G80, which is an average performer. This phone is also runs with the MIUI 12 with the same operating system of Android version 10 based. The performance of this Poco M2 is good and there is no lag or heating issues will found while the phone comes into the sale. At my point of view, the performance of the phone will be good and it won't get lag or hang while you're using the phone lightly. But when you use it continuously to play high graphics games, it may lag at sometimes. The phone also contains the 5000 mAh battery with an 18W fast charger, which is also included in the box itself. This phone is also contains the IR blaster. The Poco M2 can take some average photos and videos, whereas in rear there is an quad camera setup with an primary lens of 13 MP, 5 MP of ultra wide, 2 MP of each depth and micro lens, and it can take up to 4K at 30 FPS as a video. In front, there is an 8 MP primary notch camera, and it can push up to 1080p full HD. So finally, about the security. The security means the fingerprint sensor. The fingerprint sensor of the Poco M2 Pro is the side mounted, and it works really faster. The fingerprint sensor of the Poco M2 is in rear. So that's all about this video of the comparison between these two phones, Poco M2 and Poco M2 Pro. The base variant of this Poco M2 is 6GB RAM 64GB, which costs 11,000, and the base variant of the Poco M2 Pro is 4GB RAM 64GB, which costs 14,000. But I just buy the 6GB RAM 64GB variant, which costs 15,000 only. The comparison winner of these two phones is definitely the Poco M2 Pro, because the Poco M2 Pro have the good performance, good cameras, and the good build quality, and all of them. But when you go for a budget, it's a budget killer to say that the M2 Pro is a winner. If you are in the budget zone, you can choose M2, but if there is no budget problem for you, then directly you can choose the M2 Pro because it's the best. So the Poco M2 will be on the sale at 15th September 12 noon. But the Poco M2 Pro is already in sale. So that's all of it. If you like the video, hit the like button or the dislike button, and share your opinions on the comment box, and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Share with your friends. So thanks for watching.